Afghan journalists are growing increasingly doubtful if the Taliban will make good on its vow of a more moderate rule, including having an independent media in the country. Details in this report.
Women's rights and free speech have been hard-fought gains in Afghanistan over the last two decades of war. When last in power in 2001, the Taliban had barred women from holding jobs. But in what would have been unthinkable back then, a female journalist interviewed a Taliban spokesperson earlier this week after the group secured power in the capital, Kabul. In their first press conference since capturing the city, the Islamist militant movement said Tuesday it would allow free media and jobs for women. But some journalists aren't convinced. Saad Moseni, who heads the largest private broadcaster in Afghanistan, told Reuters on Thursday it's too early to tell what the Taliban's policies will be.
The laissez-faire approach is more a reflection of not having enough bandwidth than a specific policy that they would allow media to carry on business as usual, as they have been over the last two decades. So I wouldn't get too excited. It's only been like, you know, 72 hours. I mean, it's since they took over the city, and it's just their senior officials are just arriving in Kabul, you know, like now.
A Taliban spokesperson said on Tuesday that media must not work against Islamic values and that women could work, quote, within the framework of Islam.
It's interesting that some of them are interviewed, they refuse to look at the woman, they look at the camera person. So it's they do it, but they do it in a way that you can see that they're uncomfortable. Whereas the guy in the studio the other day was sort of a senior, one of their senior outreach communications person was quite comfortable looking at the presenter.
Media watchdogs have reported incidents this week of Afghan journalists being beaten, harassed, or raided at their homes. In one example, a presenter on state-owned Radio Television Afghanistan, Sahar Nasari, wrote on Facebook that members of the Taliban took his camera and beat up his colleague while he was trying to film a story in Kabul. He said, quote, "It has become clear there is a gap between action and words." A Taliban spokesperson did not respond to a request for comment on accusations that it has harassed journalists, and particularly women in the profession.
The Taliban urges Afghanistan's imams to call for unity as protests against its takeover spread to more cities. The details in this report.
Protests against the Taliban have now spread to more Afghan cities, and several more people have been killed at the rallies, according to witnesses, by either the militants firing their weapons or the panic and stampedes caused by it. This video was filmed by Reuters near one of the protests in the capital, Kabul. A witness in the area said that it appeared to be Taliban firing their weapons into the air. Although on Wednesday, media reported that Taliban fighters fired directly into a crowd of other protesters in the city of Jalalabad, killing three people. And on Thursday, a witness at a protest in the city of Assadabad said more people were killed there, although it wasn't clear if they were killed by gunfire, a stampede, or both. A Taliban spokesperson was not immediately available for comment. August 19th is the day that Afghanistan typically celebrates its Independence Day, when it gained independence from British rule in 1919. Some of the gatherings have been small in size, but it underlines the challenge facing the Taliban to govern the country and project a more moderate image. Meanwhile, dramatic new images have been pouring in from Kabul's airport as U.S. and allied forces struggle to keep the massive crowds inside and outside under control. A little girl here being lifted over the perimeter fence by American troops filmed on Tuesday. On Wednesday, tear gas as the soldiers try to keep the crowds back. Thousands of people are here. As of Thursday, about 8,000 Afghans and foreigners have been evacuated, according to a Western official. The U.S. alone says it's trying to get out 22,000 at-risk Afghans.